In 1912, James S. Woods, John Shearer, and Libby Carson went for a walk through the city. Over a period of months, they explored various downtown Toronto neighborhoods in search of an ideal location for the establishment of a new settlement house. At the dawn of the last century, the city was a vastly different place from the one we inhabit today. Poverty, overcrowding, dilapidated housing, poor hygiene, they were commonplace. Many families, newly arrived from the bustling ports of Europe, lacked even basic medical care. A social infrastructure we'd recognize today was simply non-existent. Encouraged by a reform movement within the Presbyterian Church of Canada, Woods, Shearer, and Carson were determined to play a role in a process of relieving some of these social ills. After an extensive search, they came upon an abandoned 12-room house on Bellevue Place. The building was located in the working-class, ethnically diverse Kensington Market District. St. Christopher House had found a home. Over time, Bellevue Place was renamed Wales Avenue, and St. Christopher House became a hub for community activity. Within 1 year of opening, staff at the house had assisted in establishing Toronto's first well baby clinic. As a reprieve from the city's stifling overcrowding, the house purchased land on the shores of Lake Scugog and operated Camp St. Christopher on that property. A unique feature about St. Christopher House back then, and a quality they continue to be respected for in the present, is that they never sought to change the community. Instead, they changed with the community. From the beginning, staff sought community input, asking, "What should our role be in facilitating the changes the community desires?" I'm Jay Jackson, and St. Christopher House has played an integral part in my life. Growing up in the 40s on Brunswick Avenue, my parents attended numerous social functions at 67 Wales. As for me, I have spent a lifetime at St. Chris. As a youngster, I was cared for by the nursery school staff, and later on, I attended the summer camp at Lake Scugog, and as a young man, I was a member of a variety of St. Chris clubs and participated in a range of social activities. As an active member of the St. Chris alumni, I'm proud to say my experience isn't unique. Throughout its existence, it is no exaggeration to state that St. Chris has impacted on the lives of tens of thousands of individuals, families, and community members. St. Christopher House operates programs and services in several locations, encompassing a community from Bloor Street South to Lakeshore Boulevard, from Bathurst Street West to Roncesvalles Avenue. From the beginning, St. Christopher House has offered a variety of programs geared toward children and youth. St. Chris continues to recognize the importance of both encouraging and providing opportunity to the young citizens of West End Toronto. At the 248 Ossington site, children up to 6 enjoy a friendly, safe environment while attending the always stimulating preschool program. Here, family and caregivers interact, learn, and play together. Entering elementary school can be a daunting experience for children 4 and 5 years of age, not to mention their caregivers. Considering this, St. Chris provides a popular 2-week summer school readiness program. St. Chris also operates an after-school program at 3 locations: the Ossington Avenue site, St. Luke's Catholic School, and Holy Family Elementary School in Parkdale. In addition to the popular sports clubs, the after-school program comprises numerous additional clubs such as the Mad Science Club, the Around the World Club, and the Healthy Lifestyles Club, to name a few. The goal of the after-school programs is to provide recreational, social, and educational activities throughout the school year. In addition to summer, winter, and March break day camps, the house offers youth drop-ins, leadership programs, and a graffiti transformation project. During the school year, there's an after-school tutoring program at St. Chris. Children are matched with volunteer tutors who assist learners in a variety of subjects. Through one-on-one tutoring, games, and activities, children's comprehension improves, resulting in them feeling better about themselves. A boost in confidence leading to academic success reveals opportunity for achievement, which otherwise may not be realized.
Chase our tail, no one will stop us. We have no masters here.
Throughout St. Christopher House's history, music instruction has been a defining feature of its mandate. Its music school is well known and respected. In operation for more than 75 years, the music school has a proud tradition of offering musical instruction to all in the community. Throughout the year, the school hosts a variety of fundraising events and concerts. Even the students get involved raising funds in the annual Performathon. There's no debating the fact that music has a positive impact on our lives. This explains the popularity of the various programs the music school offers. There's individual lessons provided by committed, knowledgeable instructors, an instrument bank, music theory classes and choirs, which include the ever-popular Toronto Song Lovers, and the recently formed Children's Choir. The scope of services provided by St. Christopher House is immense. With this in mind, it's no wonder that approximately 500 volunteers actively participate in the various programs throughout the house. Besides serving the seniors' community, the house also provides services for people with disabilities and their caregivers. One such service is the transportation program. Often taken for granted, a means of transportation being able to get around is vital for individuals intent on maintaining independence. Here we find another example of the numerous community partnerships St. Chris has formed. The transportation program operates in affiliation with Toronto Ride. It can be as imperative as going to a medical appointment or simply wishing to visit a friend. St. Chris and their partner provide responsive and affordable door-to-door services to meet individualized needs. Since 1965, the house has operated a Meals on Wheels program. Over the years, the program has kept pace with the changing diversity of its clients. The program operates almost entirely on the generosity of volunteers. Clients living on their own say that Meals on Wheels is a lifeline, providing an alternative to institutional care. You can count on St. Chris to put a new spin on the traditional delivery method. They call it Meals on Two Wheels, and as you may have guessed, deliveries are made on bicycles. Operating seasonally, this unique delivery technique both engages a younger, more urban volunteer, not to mention being environmentally responsible. Seniors in the community who wish to venture out of their homes may attend the many programs offered at St. Chris. One of these is the Elderly Persons Center, also known as EPC. EPC offers a variety of activities designed to promote personal growth in an environment that embraces the diversity of the community. The Elderly Persons Center implements and evaluates its many activities in conjunction with the EPC Members Council. Activities include fitness classes, a drop-in, arts and craft classes, and games such as cards and bingo. These activities, so important for older adults who wish to socialize, are offered in English, Portuguese, and Vietnamese. EPC programs are not strictly for socializing, though. Like all of us, seniors strive to stay current on issues of the day. To meet this need, EPC provides educational workshops as well as members' meetings. Seniors who possess a flair for the dramatic